Second type of voids possible in three-dimensional closed packet structures are octahedral voids. How is it formed? See here, about octahedral void, here we have a picture. You see, blue colored circles or spheres, they are from one layer. These black colored spheres, they are from its above or below layer. Now, see, three spheres of one layer and three spheres of another layer, they exactly when they are one above the other, they form octahedral void. But here what happens is, three spheres when they are in contact, there will be a triangular void. See, when these blue color circles are in contact, see, there is a black color triangle, sorry, blue color triangle. Similarly, when black color circles also in contact, there is another triangle, black, but it is having its vertex. See, for blue color triangle, vertex is upward. But for black colored, this black colored triangle, it is having vertex downward. So here spheres, these spheres, each three spheres in layer form a triangular void. One triangular void is having its vertex upward and another triangular void is having its vertex downward. Now these two form an empty space inside. That empty space formed by these six spheres, three from one layer, three from its next layer, is called octahedral void. Now, see the open structure for the formation of octahedral void. See, these are spheres of one layer. These three are spheres of its next layer. See, there is a triangle which is having its vertex downward. This triangle is having its vertex upward. If you join all these spheres, see, you will get an octahedron. So the empty space formed inside by all these six spheres of two layers is called octahedral void. So how is octahedral void formed? An octahedral void is formed from six spheres. From each layer, three spheres. From one layer, three spheres. And from its next layer, three spheres. So here, three spheres, when they are in contact, they form a triangular void. But that triangular void is having, from one set of three spheres, triangular void is having its vertex upward. From another set of three spheres, its triangular void is having vertex downward. Now, one triangle is like this, another triangle is like this. Now, between these two set of three spheres, there is some empty space formed. That empty space formed is called octahedral void. Now, let's see some points about this octahedral void. First, about coordination number of this octahedral void. See, this octahedral void is surrounded by how many spheres? Yes, six spheres. That's why, see here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this octahedral void is formed by six spheres. And these six spheres occupy a regular octahedron. That's why coordination number of octahedral void is six. Second one. In this octahedral void, what is the radius? Radius of an octahedral void equals to 0.414 into radius of sphere. So this is the formula to calculate radius of octahedral void. Similarly, number of octahedral voids, how many in a unit cell? Number of octahedral voids is exactly equal to the number of effective atoms per unit cell. Number of octahedral voids is equal to number of effective atoms per unit cells. That means in simple cubic system, there is effective atoms 1, that's why octahedral void 1. In BCC, effective atoms 2, that's why octahedral voids 2. In FCC, number of effective atoms 4, so octahedral voids 4. Okay, so this is about octahedral void. Now, in these two voids, which is larger? Which void is larger? Tetrahedral or octahedral? Yes, octahedral void is larger than tetrahedral void. So when we compare size, what is the order? In three-dimensional closed packed layers, we have three types of voids. One is tetrahedral void, other one is octahedral void, other one is cubical void. Cubical void is obtained only in simple cubic geometry. In simple cubic geometry only, cubical void is obtained. So see, size of all these voids, least size is of tetrahedral void, next octahedral void, large size is cubical void. This cubical void is possible only in simple cubic system. What is the formula for tetrahedral void? It is 0. See, earlier I gave a formula for tetrahedral void. It is 0.225. 0.225 into radius of atom. For octahedral void, 0.414 into radius of atom. For a cubical void, 0.732 into radius of atom. See, when you compare these values, so which is a large-sized void? Yes, cubical void is large-sized. But cubical void is possible only in simple cubic system. That's why we generally talk about tetrahedral void and octahedral void.